calculate average speed. That means if you have a trip with different rates of speed going on, how do you find the average rate of speed for the whole trip? Consider this problem. If you run for 1 mile and it takes you 5 minutes, and then you start walking and you go 4 more miles in 80 minutes, what's the average speed of the entire trip? How would we figure that out? Well, I'll tell you what we won't do. Do not average those speeds, because the distance isn't the same and the time isn't the same. You cannot just average the two speeds to get the average speed of the whole trip. It's got to be spread out evenly. And it's a simple formula, really. You just need to find the total distance and divide by the total time. So let's look at that problem again. All right, the total distance is 1 mile plus 4 more miles. And the total time is simply 5 minutes plus 80 minutes. So altogether, we've got 5/85 miles per minute, but that's kind of a weird way to leave our answer. For one thing, we could reduce it. It reduces to 1/17 of a mile per every minute. So that's the fraction way. If you want to change it to a decimal equivalent, it's not going to be equal. This is the only exact answer. But if you wanted to round it off, we'd get about 0.059 miles per minute. In this class, we keep 3 decimal places of accuracy when the instructions don't tell you otherwise. So this is an acceptable answer. Just remember to use that approximately symbol when you're rounding to show that you know that's not an exact answer. Let's try one more example. This one's a little more complicated. First of all, let's look at the graph. We have hours on the x-axis and we have miles on the y-axis. So as the graph moves to the right, time is marching on, and that's not going to stop for anything. You can't stop time, so it's continuous. In the vertical direction, miles can be stopped. So as you see, from A to B, we're making progress because the line is rising. But from B to C, it looks like they either took a nap or maybe they ate lunch. We don't know. But they stopped the car. That's what you can tell by that flat line. And then from C to D, the car starts moving again. But why is it going downward? That means that the miles are going backwards. That's just a way to indicate that they're retracing their steps, so to speak, but on the road. That still is distance, and we're going to count that. And then finally, from D to E, they go a long distance in a short amount of time. So that steep line indicates a lot of speed. Let's find the average speed for that whole trip. Remember, we're looking for total distance over total time. So let's look how much distance was covered. From A to B, the distance started at 0, and at B, the distance is at 60. So the difference is 60. So far, our distance is 60 plus. From B to C, there is no distance change. Starts at 60, ends at 60. So we didn't go anywhere. Like I said, the car stopped for some reason. From C to D, it starts at 60 and ends up at about 20. It looks like the scale is 10 on this graph. So the distance traveled is 40. I'm not going to call it negative 40, just 40. And then finally, from D to E, we go from mile marker 20 to mile marker 210. So if we subtract those, the total distance covered is 190 miles. Okay, we're going to add those together to get our total distance for the whole trip. Time is easier. As I said before, it doesn't stop for anything. That's why there's no breaks in the graph. It continues to the right the whole time. And so we end up at E, which is at the 25-hour mark. So the total time that's gone by is 25 hours. And there are all of our numbers. Well, let's add some stuff together here. This is easy. We've got 100 plus 190 over 25. We can reduce that a little bit. So if we divide everything by 5, that's 58/5 in miles per hour. But that's a little bit weird. I'm going to change it to a mixed number first so that it makes a little bit more sense in miles per hour. That would be 11 3/5 miles per hour. Now we can start to picture this. an average speed of only about 11 miles per hour. That's pretty slow as an average. You can also change that to an exact decimal equivalent, 11.6 miles per hour. Either answer, totally fine with me. And that is how you find average speed. Not so tough, right? Go do it.